Mr. President, your work speaks for itself. You have been a champion of education, and I'm sure when the history of free secondary education is being written, your name will find itself in some pages. When the argument heated up about double track and what it is and what it was not, we had an ally in the national PTA. We had an ally in the regional PTA. And we had allies among every one of you because you supported us. You saw the need in making sure that secondary education became the norm for every child in every community. Really doesn't matter whether they were rich or they were poor. It is your passion for the support of this program that has been rolled out by the government that I believe has also brought you here today. It has brought you here to find answers. It has brought you here to look for opportunities to collaborate with the government in making sure that your future of your children will be secure. And that is why I believe you are here today. And I want to assure you that this president has a vision for education like none other. I've always told people that, you know, in Ghana, when you talk about industrialization, you cannot forget Kwame Nkrumah. When you talk about rural development, even if he was prime minister for a short period, you cannot write off Prime Minister Buzia and President Akufo-Addo. And when you talk about Operation Feed Yourself, a champion comes to mind, right? Then when you talk about electrification, you are never going to be able to take President Rawlings' name from the books of history. His vision has brought electrification, has put Ghana at a level where we are comparable with South Africa. It took a vision. Now you talk about school infrastructure development. President Mills, President Mahama, look at the E-blocks, and they did a good job building school buildings.